I've got all the, well, the pens that I use the most pulled out today because I've really not spent much time maintaining, doing the maintenance stuff, which is something I recommend everybody does on a regular basis. I've just been too tied up with stuff. So everyone will recognize, those who've been on my channel know this pen is the Montegrappa Extra 1930, and if we get a close up, this is the pen I've it's got sterling silver fittings, so that's the clip, the engraved band, the little bit in the top that gives the year 1912, which is related to Montegrappa, and it's got a sterling silver section, 18K gold nib, which is to be expected in such pens. Let's just see if this thing focuses correctly. There you go. And you can see the engraving on the nib. It's a two-tone nib. So they got this very Chinese, it's Greek really, I would think, but even though the pen's Italian, of Italian heritage, the design at least, this pattern, it reminds me of a. Yeah, it is Greek, but I remember my mom bought a ring in Greece with a similar pattern. But unfortunately, I've damaged the piston end. It's because I don't use this pen much, and I believe some ink has got chalked up in there. And when I was, I'm always gentle with my stuff. It's just that I couldn't, when I got to the end, it just felt like friction within the piston rather than being the very end. And so I went past that and I heard a cracking sound. So, anyways, this pen does need a service and then that can be fixed. I don't really use this much because two things, it doesn't hold much ink, and both the Montegrappas are in a medium nib. And I didn't have time to send this to Richemont, which I really should have done in the outset. But what's lovely is the celluloid on this. This is the turtle brown. The other one I have is the bamboo black. So it really is a gorgeous pen. And the nib is buttery, buttery smooth. But I would prefer it to be abroad because now all my Montblancs now, apart from I think the Lauvbrock, are broads or double broads. So I'm going to put this one away at least for the time being. And yeah, put that one away in the can. And I can put this with the other Montegrappa. Ooh, what's up with this case? This case is a little bit on the stiff side. Let's see. Oh, there you go. It's in. So this is the Sailor. What's it called? I think it's a 1911 executive with the Naginata Togi nib, favorite nib. So let me just. So this is. There's no plan to this video. I'm just going to fill my pens as I normally do. I normally keep a record of stuff. So this pen was last supposedly filled on 29 January. Oh, it does sell right. So today is, I believe, 27th of Feb. So let's write that down. Seventeen, and so we'll just say I'm going to refill sailor with MB Racing Green. Okay, so I'm not making the best effort to write as nicely as possible there. Yeah, just scribbling away because you have quite a bit of things to get done, and I don't want to spend too much time on this task. So this is a cartridge filler. Doesn't seem like this needs to be refilled, but let me just see if there's any play. I'm going to do it upside down actually, so I can see if any bubbles rise to the top. Like, well, that's an easier trick. Then you can see how much of it is. Yeah, there we go. Nothing coming to the surface still. And there we go. Now I'm getting. I can see some air bubbles coming through. And there we go. I reached the point. So this much is empty. So I could just try and top it up. Let's see. I've got two bottles of Racing Green here. I think Racing Green is hard to come by now. So when it was being taken off the market, I basically bought a lot of Racing Green. So I still do have a couple of bottles left. And the same for Blue Black, which is their Iron Gall Ink. Let's just do that. So I normally assume this pose because it's the older Mont Blanc bottle. It lets me tip it forward and hold the pen at the same time. And as you can see, and if you look at my previous pen-related video, you will notice how I tend to touch the inner edge of the bottle using both sides of the nib. It's not scraping it, I'm just gently touching it, because capillary action itself will cause the ink to flow back into the bottle. That way you're saving ink, and when you're doing this, you're anyways you're saturating the nib with ink. So you can either dab it onto bit of paper, like, well, you know, this is basic kitchen paper. You can dab it and then just get any excess off. So you can see it's I didn't waste too much in doing that anyways. So that's now topped up, and so that pen's ready to go for probably another week, I think. It depends how much I'm writing with, and where's the cap. Okay, so that's one down with Racing Green. We'll keep this side because I might switch another pen to Racing Green, depending on how things go. So let's see what we have here. So we have the Agatha Christie. Okay, we have another Agatha Christie. Oh yeah, I've not used this for a while because I'm going to be posting another video, but I've been rewiring my entire computing setup. And I tend to work in this space. And so with everything being moved around, furniture being moved around, I put the precious pens away, put that way. So now I have the Duma over there. So I just want to see what I last wrote to do with, here we go. Alexander Duma, Racing Green. So this is another quick sketch, scratch pad thingy, Monte Carlo Turtle Brown, Christie Sterling Silver. Oh, so that has the Mont Blanc Bordeaux. Okay. So I will need to fetch the Bordeaux in a bit. And the Vermeil has J. Herb in Blue Nuit. Okay. So the Blue Nuit, let's do that first then. Because this is my favorite pen, I would say, right now. Oh, not right now, for a good while. Where is it, J. Herb? So unfortunately, I finished my J. Herb in Blue Nuit, which is my favorite ink, easily my favorite ink. So I ended up putting the last dregs that I have into this Mont Blanc bottle. So I'm going to try and be as careful as possible not to waste any. And I always like to do a quick test just to see. And another trick is you can do that and then blot it just to see, oh yeah, whether that's the same ink, just to be sure. So let's see how much have I used. Oh, there you go. Oh, it's all right. It's almost it's pretty full. So that's good news, I suppose. But because there's so little, and this I have to basically drench it sideways. Yeah, there wasn't much being done there, but anyways, it's a mild top up, so. And the same trick, just let any excess go back into the bottle off the nib. There you go. So that takes care of that. And I left a bit of excess on the top of the thing, so on the lip. I can just wipe off any that's rubbed on the section so it doesn't come out of my hand when I'm using it next time. So that's the Vermeil. So this is actually going to go back onto my desk. Like, this is my regular pen. And this gets capped. And now this one, we're going to do a bit of work on this pen, because this is sterling silver. And it needs to, so this is a very old Montblanc silver polishing cloth. They gave it free of charge, but you can source these, or any silver buffing cloth basically. So you can see how the snake looks at the moment, pretty dull. And I'm going to give it a bit of a shine, already just one bit of a rub and it's already sparkling a bit more. So let me just, so just think that you're Aladdin and you're rubbing your lamp. it's just a bit of rubbing. There's nothing more to this. You just want to get the tarnish off the snake. Just go from all the angles. And just be gentle. I'm just lightly rubbing. I'm not giving any excess pressure or anything of the sort. It's just rubbing the tail. This is the tail section that wraps around the cap. So it seems the tail has oxidized a bit more, so it will need a fair bit more polishing. Yeah, that looks all right, and we can try and go to the inner bit of the tail. So, oops, let me try and do it like that. So after I'm getting rid of the groove inside. Yeah, so that looks nice already. There we go, it's already well polished. And then we have the sterling silver band at the bottom. So for this, I'm just rubbing around it. Oops. Okay. So I think that's enough for that. And then, where's the pen? Well, there's one little band down here on the piston cap. But I don't know how much. I can just do like this sideways, because I can just maybe get a bit of the edge. Yeah, it seems to be catching it a bit. So that's all I need, just to give it a little bit of a polish. These are vintage pens after all, so better be gentle then regret something by cracking something. So yeah, these are from I think 93. I think the Hemingway was 92, so this is the second edition of the writer's edition, so these are very special in that sense. Yeah, and this Agatha Christie is an edition of 3000. No, sorry, what am I saying? My pen is serial number 3000. The edition is 19,859. That's an interesting number for me to receive. quite a low number as well. Where did I put? Oh, sorry. What am I doing? Lost my marbles there. Here we go. So the Vermeil. No, I'm totally losing my marbles. How is that possible? Oh yeah, okay. That's strange. So on this pen, they have got the full edition on the left, meaning the total number of pens, and the particular serial for this pen on the right. On the Vermeil, it's the other way around. This is a set of 4,810, and that's the height of the Mont Blanc mountain. So 4810 is plastered on the Meisterstock nibs. But my pen is serial number, it's either 600 or 842. I would need a loop to see that. My sight isn't so good these days. So this is a 20,000 odd release. And so this is the Bordeaux, so I would need to fill this one later on. So I can come back to doing that later on. And let's do the Stormy Gray next, because this is another one that I use every day. So the ones that I don't use that often can be done later on. So this is the Stormy Gray. Pretty sure it is, yes. This is the Stormy Gray. And this is also by J. Herbin. The anniversary edition inks are just fabulous. They're absolutely fabulous. So I'm gonna put the polishing cloth away for now, which I can get to later on. And so let's keep that there. I just want to test this. So this ink has gold flecks, which is actually, hang on, I can tighten the bottle up. So this ink has gold flecks inside the bottle. If I were to roll it around very gently, there you go, you see all the gold deposited at the bottom. So really one should shake the bottle to get all the gold particles back into the ink. So I'm just going to, oops, there we go, I think I got some ink coming out, right? Now, if you're not used to what I'm doing, be very careful, because the last thing you want is to insert ink, the wrong ink, into a bottle and contaminate your inks. For me, it's easier because I tend to assign an ink that I like to a certain pen, in the sense that this pen has been Stormy Gray for a very long time. And I keep this as my Stormy Gray pen, put that way. That way it's easier for me to, through the week, refill pens as needed. I've already touched the inside. There's a bit more coming through. Okay. But that's just general capillary reaction as well. So tightening on that one, and then I can grab my journal again, and I can just say, what did we do? We topped up the Vermeil, right? Vermeil, topped up. Whoop, topped up. That's all. This needs to. Okay, still not writing properly, but never mind. So it is filled with J. Herbin. Stormy Gray. Okay, so that's got a record in there. And so this can also go onto my desk for this week's rotation. And I think I will stop the clip there, because I need to figure out what inks I want for the Duma is racing green. Well, I can do that, can't I? because the jewels worn, I need to pick up and pick out a new ink. I need to flush this. So actually, I can do two things. I can keep the video going a bit longer. I can look to flush this pen. I don't know if I, because I've had this piston left in the open position for a long time. I should have never done that. So let's just run the piston. So I'm basically filling the pen with fresh water. This is fresh water. Oh, there you can see. So I need to figure out what blue this is. I think it's, looking back at my journal, J. Herbin. No, this is, sorry, what, this is the, not the, what's it called? That's interesting. The Jules Verne hasn't been given a record. So I'm just going to scroll back. So yeah, I'm flipping pages and I'm calling scroll back. It shows how much I'm using. Oh, here we go. So yeah, this is also Blue Nui. This is also J. Herbin Blue Nui. So I need to basically order more Blue Nui. So that's why I need to find another ink for this pen. This was already pre-flushed once before. That's why the piston had been left open. So it looks like I just wasted a lot of ink, but I didn't. It's just remnants inside the piston, inside the car, you know, the cavity. So with that done, it's good to always have a couple of these on hand. And by that, I mean fresh glasses of water. And then I can repeat the procedure where I'm filling it with fresh water again. And then you can see now it says far less ink coming out. We can get it into a cleaner area of fresh water and put the pen further down. I normally don't dip it that far, actually. I never dip the section in. But I did that just because I'm on this video, so I need to be careful. And switching over to another glass of water. That felt a little dry. And we can just do one more last flush here. So in this, it's barely nothing. So I can. You at this level, I can just mix in, as in, fill it with a different brand of blue ink. I'll most likely just use a Mont Blanc blue because I have that on hand. Till I can order. Right. So I'm keeping the piston open so that I know it's now flushed, ready to be refilled. And we'll put that away as well. And then a good indicator of, so this is a decent indicator. You can see that there isn't much being dabbed off the pen. So I think, this is a good point to wrap up the video because it's starting to get a bit long. If you like these kind of pen related videos, comment and let me know in the comment section below. And then I will post more of these regularly. And I'm planning to get the rest of the pens out of the vault and do a decent rotation and introduce some of the Mont Blanc 149s back in the rotation, because I have, what, four 149s or five 149s, I can't remember. And they've been flushed and kept in storage for a good while. So it'll be nice to give those pens, get them back into the rotation. So thanks again for watching, subscribe, give me a like, and I look forward to hearing from you. Thanks again, bye bye.